History of violence ought to be named the archaeology of violence because the central character's past is not something lying at a distance of time from the present. But as the film unfolds, we see that his past identity persists beneath a layer of his present identity. Viggo Mortensen stars as a family man, Tom Stahl, living in a small town in the American Midwest. He is married to Edie Stahl and they have two children. In an early scene in the film, we witness the admirable persistence of love in their married life.
Hey, good looking.
Where are we going?
Still capable of sexual excitement, play, and imagination, his wife decides to sneak him into her parents' farmhouse, take him to her upstairs childhood bedroom, and tells him she wants to revise her own history. Just because she did not have the erotic joy of knowing him when she was a high school girl discovering her own sexual development.
What have you done with my wife?
She would like to revisit her early sexual self-discovery and interject her husband into that young girl's fantasy.
Quiet, my parents are in the next room.
In a post-sex glow, he tells her of his vivid memory of the moment he really knew that she really loved him. It was in her eyes. He noticed something about the way that she looked at him.
I remember the moment I knew you were in love with me. I saw it in your eyes. I can still see it.
Of course you can.
The story then begins to take an unexpected turn when mild-mannered Tom performs an impulsive and dramatic act of heroism.
Shut up, bitch!
Okay, Billy. Let's show this asshole we mean business.
What? Her?
Yes, her. Do her!
News spreads.
Thank you so much. Look.
His picture and story becomes a national spectacle of the all-American boy next door capable of dispatching bad men with bravery, agility, and moral clarity.
Mr. Stahl, Jenny Wyatt, WRPK News.
It is not long before he is paid a visit by more bad men from out of town.
Oh, look, more reporters. Nice.
They don't look like reporters.
There is a reiteration of the theme of the knowledge by sight and of the eye when we see that one of these professional bad guys who show up at his workplace has what looks like a glass eye.
Think we know each other?
You tell me.
The men accuse him of not being who he says he is.
Pennsylvania? Is that where you gentlemen from?
Yeah, like you don't know.
That he is actually a gangster named Joey Cusack, who had dealings with the Irish mob in Philadelphia.
I want to thank you for the coffee, Joey.
It's Tom. My name's Tom Stahl.
They stalk him. And finally confront him at his home, intending to kidnap him and return him to Philadelphia, where they claim he has unsettled business and people to account to.
Now, come on, Joey, get in the car. You won't need your toothbrush. We'll take care of everything.
It'd be better if you just leave now.
Joey.
Both his wife and son watch in horror as their father turns deliberately and decisively murderous.
Well, Joey, let's go.
Oh!
You got anything to say before I blow your brains out, you miserable prick?
I should have killed you back in Philly.
Yeah, Joey. You should have.
He now has another serious problem. His wife no longer trusts him. How can she love someone who not only has lied to her, she actually does not know who he really is?
Did you do it for money, or did you do it because you enjoyed it?
Joey did. Both. I didn't. Tom Stahl didn't.
In fact, she suspects elements of psychiatric disorder when he claims that he killed that person, Joey, that he once was, and he is now a different person.
I thought I killed Joey Cusack. I went out to the desert and I killed him. I spent 3 years becoming Tom Stahl.
But she has seen the killer Joey in action. She knows that this past version of himself is not dead. In fact, is clearly capable of spontaneous eruption.
What do you think you heard?
It's not what I heard. It's what I saw. I saw Joey. I saw you turn into Joey right before my eyes.
Since family love is an equal motif, it turns out that the person in Philadelphia who wants to retrieve him is his older brother, Richie Cusack.
Hey, boy. You're still pretty good with the killing.
Whose life and career in organized crime was greatly frustrated when his little brother Joey apparently killed too many of the wrong people before he left town and changed his ways and identity and became a normal person.
You know you crossed me.
Tom slash Joey knows that he and his family are now in danger. Like the action of a character in a classic Greek tragedy, he realizes that he must return to Philadelphia and answer to his brother Richie to end the danger to his family. Like Odysseus, who returns home and kills all of his wife's suitors, he now has liberated the danger to his family, and all that remains is the question of how his wife will see him. Will she recognize the man to whom she once was so endeared? In other words, can she confirm his desire to be good merely by seeing him as such? Can she, like a reverse Gorgon, give him life through her eyes, her judgment, and her belief in his becoming? The return home is played almost with no dialogue. He arrives late at night to find his wife and two children sitting at dinner, a would-be Norman Rockwell painting if not for the obvious tension. Their daughter sets a place for him at the table. He humbly draws up a chair, avoiding eye contact with them all. It's a scene actors live to play. Eventually, he looks up and across the table to his wife, Edie, silently hoping to see if love is still there.